Ms. Denise Pua and Mr. Ang Wei Neng asked about the progress of the Third Enabling Master Plan, or EMP3. Over the past year, we have enhanced training and employment opportunities for persons with disabilities. Under the Hospital to Work Program, SG-Enable and SPD have extended assistance to persons with acquired disabilities by supporting their return to work through reskilling, goal setting, and rehabilitation through therapy. We have also extended the School to Work Program to more schools. It provides counseling, soft skills training, and work trial opportunities for students in special education schools before they are matched with suitable jobs. Mr. Ang asked if employers are becoming more receptive to employing persons with disabilities. SG-Enable works closely with employers to help them build an inclusive company culture and redesign jobs. These efforts have borne fruit. The public sector has been leading the way and hired over 70 new employees with disabilities in the past 2 years. More employees with disabilities have also been hired in the private sector. Over the past 2 years, 2,700 new employees and over 1,300 new employers have benefited from the Special Employment Credit, which supports employers in hiring employees with disabilities. To defray transport costs, we also enhanced the taxi subsidy scheme to benefit more persons with disabilities, including those attending employment-related training supported by SG-Enable. The scheme now supports up to 80% of the cost of travel, up from 50% previously, and has been extended to private hire cars. Ms. Pua asked if MSF can set up a committee to involve the community more in the implementation of EMP3. MSF chairs an inter-agency committee, which collaborates with the people and private sectors to implement the EMP3 recommendations. Community groups are closely involved in various work areas, and we will continue to approach the community for feedback, ideas, and partnerships in EMP3 initiatives. To facilitate community-driven ground-up initiatives, we have also created several channels to provide on funding support. As we strengthen support for persons with disabilities, let us not forget their caregivers. The role of a caregiver is critical, but challenging, and more support will be provided to caregivers of persons with disabilities. SG-Enable today supports caregivers in their care role. This includes the information and referral to disability services provided through the SG-Enable info line and the concierge at the Enabling Village. Moving ahead, SG-Enable will further work with public sector agencies and community partners to equip caregivers with information and advice to build up their self-care and caregiving skills. It will also partner VWOs to improve caregiver support, especially at critical transition point of the care recipient's life. There's much to be gained from the support and solidarity of fellow caregivers. To facilitate this, SG-Enable will be setting up a caregiver space at the Enabling Village by the end of the year. It will serve as a place for activities organized by peer support groups, as well as caregiver training and engagement by VWOs and community partners. We want caregivers to come, learn from the experiences of fellow caregivers, and get advice and moral support as they walk their caregiving journey. This will strengthen their network of support for caregivers, which Mr. Desmond Chu spoke about. Mr. Chu also highlighted the importance of respite care in improving caregivers' well-being. Ample respite care services are provided at 7 adult disability homes and 3 children disability homes, supported by mean-tested subsidies of up to 75%. With more caregivers remaining in the workforce, the demand for daycare may grow, as Mr. Ang noted. We will add another 200 day activity center places this year for adults with disabilities. We are also building up the center's capabilities to support persons with moderate to severe needs with quality programming and intervention services. Another issue that preoccupies caregivers is the care of their loved ones with disabilities upon their death. Caregivers will be better supported with care and financial planning for their dependents. The Special Needs Trust Company, or SNTC, is a non-profit trust company which provides subsidized trust services. It has served more than 500 families since its inception 10 years ago. One family that benefited from its service is the Yaps. Mr. Yap and his son Honwi, who has cerebral palsy, live in a rental flat. Mr. Yap was diagnosed with cancer last year and worries about Honwi's long-term care needs, and he has no other familial support. Mr. Yap approached SNTC to set up a trust for his son. Now, Mr. Yap is assured that if his son outlives him, his savings, including CPF monies, will be safeguarded, invested, and paid out according to a care plan customized to meet Honwi's needs. Many more caregivers of loved ones with disability can benefit from such peace of mind. SNTC will be stepping up its outreach to caregivers to raise awareness on the care planning and financial education available to them. Over the next 5 years, SNTC will work with community partners, including the SSOs, to reach out to more than 1,700 caregivers of persons with disabilities. We will also enhance the application processes to schemes and services that support caregivers. As Mr. Murali previously highlighted, persons with cognitive disabilities sometimes face difficulties in being assessed for schemes. Their caregivers will soon be able to apply for the Foreign Domestic Worker Levy concession and grant with greater ease. MSF have worked with MOH to include MSF Client Assessment Form, or CAF, as an alternative tool to evaluate the level of support a person requires to person activities of daily living, to support applications for the FDW levy concession and grant. From 1st April 2018, persons with disabilities and their caregivers can approach the special education schools or disability care services, such as day activity centres, to have the assessment done on site or be linked up to the therapy hubs for the CAF assessment. We estimate that about 1,000 persons with disabilities and their caregivers could benefit from this. We will also strengthen the last mile of support, ensuring that caregivers know about our services and can access them conveniently. As my minister has announced, we are working towards making information and referrals to services by SG Enable and SNTC available at our SSOs through video conferencing. We will work with other agencies to explore equipping more frontline officers, including those from Silver Generation Office, with knowledge about disability-related schemes and services.